Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Welcome back to Iconic TV. My name is DJ Iconic Team, and today we are here again to review this controller, this Pioneer DJ SB3 controller. So today I'll be showing you, or rather telling you, some of the few things that most of the tech reviewers, they don't tell you about this controller. Yeah, and for that fact, we're going to start with the demerits, disadvantages. They are quite a number, but they cannot outdo the merits. This controller, I'd recommend this controller for anyone who's starting out to DJ, because it has all the features and the layout is way professional. Okay, one, for the demerits, this controller really feels plasticky, from the buttons to the knobs to the sliders. You can hear, right? Except for the pads, they are quite good. They are rubber. They feel so good on the hands. But for the buttons, too plasticky. Yeah, you can hear. And this tempo slider over here. Oh my goodness, it's too short. It's half the professional one. No, the turntable one or the CDJ one is quite big. So this one, you have to use the shift button to take it back, then go down again, shift up, take it down. It's quite hectic. Okay, one more thing. This controller, you can't record your mic without having an external recorder, or rather an amplifier or something else that can record audio separately. So if you out here, you connected your microphone over here, and you expect to record your voiceovers alongside your mix them, sick, you're wrong. So that is one thing that this controller, for me, that I feel that they should have considered. Yeah, another thing, this controller has really small jog wheels. See, it's only limited to about 3 to 4 fingers here. Let's just say 2 fingers. It's too small if you are a scratch junk here. But it does the job. Right here over the pads, some of them, I don't understand why they put them here. Come on, like this pad scratch, I don't understand its work at all, because why should you use these buttons to scratch it? You can use the jog wheels, unless you are just a beginner and you want to understand how the scratches should sound. But anyway, to me and to most people that I've interacted with, they find this pad scratch useless, same as the effects fade. Yeah, these two buttons, it's a no. This controller is too compact, you know what I mean, like everything is way close to one another. I wish if they would have made it a little bit longer, like the Numark Mixtrack Pro 3, it's longer, you know, to accommodate everything and to have everything spaced out. This controller too, it has limited sound output. Its sound card is not that strong, but it does the job in most situations. But for commercial or rather professional situations like big clubs, stadiums and stuff like that, these won't do. Yeah, the sound would be too, unless you have very powerful amplifiers to push out to amplify the sound. Yeah, and we're done with the demerits. Let's go back to our merits, the bright side of this controller. Let's go. So for the first one thing I love this about this controller is that it's compatible with quite a number of software, The first one, it's compatible with Virtual DJ because, you know, most people start with the mixing their laptop on Virtual DJ before they get to use their first gear. And you know, if you're starting out and then you just connect this controller to Virtual DJ, man, and you've been using Virtual DJ on your laptop all through, it's going to be an easier job for you to learn some of the tricks and skills. It's also compatible with Serato Intro and Serato DJ Pro. Tick! You know, Serato DJ Pro, this controller. Yeah, it's one thing I love about it. Another thing is that this controller, it has good latency. You know what I mean? For the scratch junkies, or rather for anyone who likes scratching, latency really matters a lot because it determines how fast you can scratch without the waves delaying and everything. So if you don't understand latency, I don't know whether I should do a separate video to explain to you what latency is and how it affects your controller, rather your DJ gear performance. But anyway, for those who understand, for now, okay, I'll do a separate video for the latency, but for now, this controller has a good latency of up to 2 milliseconds. That's how far you can go. You cannot go to one. Yeah, so the scratch will sound tighter, unlike if you're using a 20 millisecond latency of 20 milliseconds. So for this one, it's kind of tight when it comes to scratching with a latency of, oh my goodness, I'm pacing, yo, a latency of 2 milliseconds, right? Okay, another thing is that it has these trim knobs over here. Trim knobs, rather, they are also called gain knobs. For most entry level controllers, most of them lack this trim, or rather gain knobs. This one control what happens, rather the volume for the left deck and this one for the right deck. It has also this filter knob for the low pass filter and high pass filter for the left deck, same to the other deck. Another thing is that this controller, you can play up to 4 decks. This is the button that you use to switch from the second deck to the fourth. And this one used to switch from the second deck to the third deck. Yeah. This controller, oh god. Here, the layout for the pads and this Q button and this play button. Excellent. One more thing is that this controller has extra pads and extra features over here. You have beat jump, roll, slicer, and trance, which most entry level controllers lack. Yeah, this is quite something. For those who have used this controller, they understand what I'm saying. And if you want to buy a controller, make sure to get yourself the DDJ SB3 DJ controller. It's the best out there so far. Alright. So for this video, I think those are the only things that I plan to tell you guys. And one more thing is that this controller is quite affordable for the beginner. It goes for about, when it first came, it was first introduced into the market here in Kenya, it was retailing at about $50. But right now, is it 2 years down the line, or rather 1.5 years down the line? Oh yeah, 2 years down the line so far. Right now you can get it for about $35, yeah, $35, depending on the store, that is 35,000 shillings, yeah. And if you get a good deal, you can go up to $30,000, man, $30. So if you're aspiring to start DJing, go out, get this controller, man, go out, get it, yeah. Oh, please allow me to say this. Over here, for the headphones, there's an 8mm jack. I don't know whether you can see here, this is where you connect it. Over here, it's an 8mm jack. And you can choose if you want to listen to your left deck or your right deck separately, or if you want to listen to the master. Yeah. And here is where you control your headphones, rather earphones levels. Yeah, that's all I can say about this controller, and that's it for this video. See you in the next one. I'll be explaining to you about latency. Hope you enjoyed and keep it iconic. Make sure to subscribe and recommend this channel to everyone out there who wants to know about DJing gear, who wants to learn about DJing, who is someone who is starting out, and someone's just curious about DJing. Enjoy your day, enjoy your night, wherever you are. Stay safe, mask on, keep sanitizing. Bless. Goodbye for now.